In this recorded tutorial, I just want to demonstrate the power of dynamic blocks. Now, in this drawing, you can see that if I go to the Insert tab and the Insert icon and choose this Parcan 64 symbol, you can see that as soon as I go to insert it, I've actually picked it up by a certain position in the center of the yoke, in the center of the lantern. And when I go to paste it by clicking, you can see that I have a pop-up window that allows me to put some information into this symbol. Now, this is a function of dynamic blocks. This is called an attribute definition, and it allows me to put in some information as a user of this block by default. So you can see here that I've got channel number, dimmer number, unit number, color and purpose, all the sort of things that you'd expect to see on a theater lantern symbol. So I'm just going to put in some information here. Let's say that it was like this. Let's say it was unit one. Let's say color lead 201, and the purpose was general cover. And I'm just going to click OK, and you can see that information now populates that symbol. And that's one of the great things about dynamic blocks. And that can be different for every single symbol, which is great because symbols are normally the same replicated across every single symbol. And the drawing of the symbol will be, but the information that's contained within the dynamic part of the block can be different for every single light. And you can see here that I can put some more information in here. And click OK, and this has got different information to this one. Now, it goes further than that, actually. When I select this block, you can see that I get some handles, some blue nodes, and I can move the actual channel and dimmer number, and I can put this wherever I want to put it on my plan. And this one, I can put wherever I want this one. And I can rotate the symbol, and you can see that it locks to certain positions, 45 degrees, 60 degrees, 30 degrees, like this. I can rotate this arrow. Now, this arrow on a lighting symbol denotes how the lamp should be situated in the back of the unit, because a Parcan, as you may remember, has an oval beam, and I can turn that for each unit. I can also change what this unit is. So for example, at the moment it's a CP62, and I can say, well, actually it should be a CP61 type lamp, and I can change that, and the whole symbol changes depending on what I set this drop down to. Because I've created layers for these objects, I also have the ability to switch on and off the information as I wish, so I can get rid of the dimmer information or the color information or the channel, etc. Now, that is really powerful stuff because it allows you to have a symbol that you can change in your drawings as you wish. And if I just go to right click, I just select one of these and just go right click block editor, you can see that we've got quite a few different handles and parameters set here to allow that to happen. And all of these functions are set using the authoring palette, using the parameters and actions. So there's loads of things you can do with dynamic blocks. It becomes really powerful once you get the hang of it. I recommend you experiment and try out some of the parameters and actions and see what you can achieve.